Hey guys, welcome to the session 3 of Swift course. So in this session what we're going to learn is the arithmetic operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication and then division, and then the remainder operator, and then compound assignment operators, and then comparison operators like greater than, less than, and then ternary operators. I will explain all these stuffs one by one. So let's start with the arithmetic operators. So let's do the addition. So we need to let's say we need to add two numbers or three numbers, something like that. So let number 1 equal to 5, let number 2 equal to 10, let number 3 equal to 40, and let's add all these three numbers. So let result equal to num 1 plus number 2 plus number 3, okay, and then print result. So hit the play button, wait for a moment. Okay, so in this line the number 1 has 5, number 2 has 10, number 3 has 40, and then in line number 8 the result is going to have 55 it's as its result, and then when you print it, it prints the 55. So 55 is our output. Okay, so let's do some subtraction. So let number 4 equal to 50, let number 5 equal to 80, and then let number 6 equal to 90. So what I'm going to do is let result equal to, I'm going to subtract number 4 and number 5 from number 6. So what I'm going to do is number 6 minus, I'm going to subtract number 4 and number 5. Okay, result 1. The reason why that error came was we have the constant called result already at the line number 8. We cannot redeclare the same constant. So let's print result 1. So minus 40. Okay, let's do multiplication. Let x equal to 5, let y equal to 10, and let result 3 equal to x star y. Okay, and then print result 3. And the value is 50. Okay, let's try this. What if you put up like this? It will get error because star is not a prefix unary operator. You have to keep the proper spacing between the variables or constant, whatever you are using there. So x space star then space y. In case if you don't want to have the space, then what you have to do is you should not be having space in either side. You can have like this, it will work. But you you just can't have space on one side and then space, I mean, not having space on the other side. Either you should have space on the both the sides or just don't have space at all. Next, division. Let x equal to 50 and then let, okay, so we cannot redeclare x. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to divide this result 3 by y. Okay, so let result 4 equal to result 3 divided by y. Okay, so print the result 4. So when we do that, when we divide 50 divided by 10, we get the value as 5, right? Okay. So when we divide result 4 divided by 10, we get quotient as 5, right? So what is the remainder? It is 0, right? Because when we divide 50 divided by 10, we get quotient as 5 and then remainder as 0, right? So I want, so let's take an example for the remainder. So, so divide 5 by 2. So what we will be getting, we will be getting the quotient as 2 and remainder as 1, right? So how to get this remainder value? To do that, let value equal to 5, let divider equal to 2, let remainder equal to value, instead of divider we have to use percentage symbol, which is the remainder operator, and then divider. So let's print the remainder. We will be getting, we should be getting 1. You see that, right? So this is called remainder operator. So we covered arithmetic operators, remainder operator. Next, what is the third one? Compound assignment operators, right? Okay. So, for instance, let's say, let's declare variable result equal to, or salary equal to 5000. Okay, and now I want to add a bonus. Let bonus equal to 4000. So I want to add this bonus to the salary variable and also store the resultant value to the salary variable itself. Like at the end, my salary should be 9000, right? So to do that, what we have to do is salary equal to salary plus bonus, right? This is how we will be doing. Print salary. So the output of the salary will be, but actually we don't have to write this much to perform this. That's where the compound assignment operator comes in. So what we can do is salary, instead of the above line, salary plus equal to bonus. So which means this operator indirectly tells the compiler that add the bonus to the salary and store the resultant value to the salary variable itself. Okay, so let's comment that and run it. So we get this same 9000, right? Okay, so I mean here I see a lot of values are getting printed and you might get confused which one is for what, right? So let's apply whatever we learned in our previous classes. So I want to print the salary is and then the value. Okay, so to do that, what we have to do, we have to write a string called the salary after adding bonus is. What we have to do, we have to use the string interpolation thing, right? So we have to we have to use the salary variable here. To do that, put a backslash and then put the salary here and run now. So the salary after adding bonus is 9000. Okay, so this is called compound assignment operator. Maybe what you can do is even you can use these operators like minus, equal to, all those steps, or star, equal to. These are all few of the examples, like you can minus and then you can multiply, all those steps. Next, what we have to do, comparison operators. So let's apply the next thing what we learned in the previous class. We have multiple lines here, right? So what you have to do, either I have to go and put slash for each line, or what I can do, I can star slash slash, sorry, star and then slash, and within this block I can put everything, right? So this is called block comment. So let's use these operators, comparison operators. So what I'm going to do is let A equal to 5, let B equal to 10. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to compare whether A is greater than B or not. So to do that, what we have to use is statements, control statements. Okay, so we are going to use if statement now. So if A for greater than, we have to use this one, and then A greater than B, okay, then put these parentheses. So if A greater than B, then what I'm going to do is print A is greater than B. Okay, and in the next statement what I'm going to do is if B less than A, then print B is less than A. Okay, or else if A greater than or equal to B, then what we can do, print A is greater than or equal to B, right? And to check a case for this one, what I'm going to do is, okay, first comment all these things. Let's check one thing first. So execute it. So A greater than B is false, so it didn't print anything. So I'm going to uncomment the next stuff. And I'm going to put greater than here. So if B greater than A, then write it like b is greater than a. So execute it. So b is greater than a, and if I uncomment this stuff, it won't print anything because obviously a is smaller than b, right? So let's check that. It didn't print anything, right? But if a less than or equal to b, then the condition becomes true. Then a is less than or equal to b. Execute it. A is less than or equal to b. So these are all the comparison operators. Okay, so until now we are just comparing numbers. How about comparing strings? For instance, let first name equal to PJ, let last name equal to JP. Let's compare this. If first name equal to last name, print both strings are equal. Else print strings don't match. Okay, so let's execute this one. So strings don't match. So let's go and change this one. P J. And both the strings are equal. How about this one? Smaller j. Strings don't match. So this equal to compares with case sensitive. If in case if you are comparing two strings, okay, there are ways to compare two strings without case sensitive, but that we will be covering in the upcoming sessions. So we are done with this one, and then the next one is ternary operator. Okay, what is this one? This one looks weird, right? No, actually, the ternary operator is nothing but it's a combination of if else. Okay, so for instance, let total mark equal to 450. Okay, so what I am go what is my requirement is I need to print good mark if the total mark is above or greater than or equal to 450 or not good mark. Okay, so to do that, what I will be doing, if total mark greater than or equal to 450, then print good mark, else print needs improvement. Okay, so we are writing four lines of code here, right? How about writing a single line? So to achieve that, what we can do is total mark greater than or equal to 450, then print good mark, else print needs improvement. That's it. So it checks the condition first. The operation of ternary operator is it checks the condition first. In case if it is true, if it is succeeds, then it executes the first statement here. And in case if it is fails to like if the condition is false here, then it goes for the last statement. That's how the ternary operator works. So total mark is greater than or equal to 50, which is true. So it will pick up this one. Okay, so let's test this. So here one print statement is there, and then here one print statement is there. That's the reason we are getting two good mark statements here. Okay. Okay. What's the next one? Logical operators. Okay. Logical operators is nothing but like and or statements. For instance, assume that we need to give a credit to a student in case if the student scored more than 450 and also he has a attendance percentage more than 80. In that case, we let's give 1 hour to the student. So to achieve that, what we can do is let student mark equal to 460, let attendance percentage is 85. So what I'm going to do is if student mark greater than or equal to 450 and attendance percentage greater than greater than 80, then print award this student. Okay, so let's run this one. So yes, it matches, right? But for instance, if any of the thing, like let's say the student didn't come to class regularly, but he scored more than 450. For instance, let's assume that the school student only has 50% of attendance, but he scored 460 as marks. Then having this AND operator won't satisfy this condition, right? So let's confirm that. As of now, it is not awarding the student. So what we can do is we can just replace with the OR operator. Okay, so either the student mark has to be greater than or equal to 450, or if the attendance percentage is greater than 80, then award that student. So let's execute that. Now our statement getting satisfied, and then I mean it is awarding the student. So how about rechecking once again? So assume that the student scored only 300, but he has a attendance percentage of 80. Let's check that. Still, it's not awarding the student, right? Why? Because we are literally checking greater than 80, but whereas the attendance percentage of the student is 80, which is not true. So what we should have done is greater than or equal to 80. We should compare like this so that our statement will satisfy this condition and then award that student, right? So these are all the comparison, sorry, logical operators we have. So in this class, what are all the things we have learned? We learned arithmetic operators, in which we did addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and then remainder operator, and then compound assignment operators, which literally makes your code look cleaner when you use these operators, and then comparison operators like greater than, less than, greater than or equal to, less than or equal to, and then ternary operator. It's just a shorthand of if else statement. Like it checks the condition. If it is true, picks up the first statement. If it is false, then picks up the last statement. And then which learned logical operators, where we used and, we call this as OR operator, and then we call this one as AND operator. Okay, so I think for today this should be enough, I think. And if you really like this video, kindly hit the subscribe button. so that you will get notification for my future videos.